I attended Weston because the family legacy. I have aunts that previously attended in previous years, in-laws, but for some reason, Weston was the only high school that I've ever known. I attended Woodlawn Middle School, and all I knew was I'm going to Weston.
We all graduated from Garrison Junior High School. My brother and everybody else was going to Forest Park, which is where I wanted to go, but for some reason my mother said, you're going to Weston, which means I had to get on the bus, two, three buses, and go downtown to Weston when it was on Howard Street.
City was never a question for me. I wasn't interested in anything that city offered. Poly definitely wasn't in the question, so Weston was it.
I came to Weston because my mother is an extreme fan of all female institutions. My oldest sister graduated from Hood College. My middle sister attended St. Paul School for Girls, and I attended Weston.
It wasn't an option, honestly. It was, my parents said, you know, you're going to Weston. And then I would hear my friends in middle school say, yeah, I'm going to Weston too. And then you start hearing this buzz about Weston High School, and it's okay, I'm going to Weston.
And I came to Weston because it was the best. My sister went to Eastern, and she said, go to Weston.
Weston, all of the young ladies had this quality. It's a standard.
Prestigious might not be the word, but it was something. You knew that if you came through Weston, you had some smarts. You knew how to carry yourself. Weston back then, at least, was very much about being a lady and being bright. You will be a lady. You will comport yourself as a young lady, and you will be bright. You will know how to speak.
You were able to be yourself, but there was a code of ethic that you had to maintain in order to become that Western woman.
We studied hard. We did a lot of, it was a tough academic school.
Being at Western definitely meant to be on my P's and Q's. You couldn't mess up, and it was easy to mess up. And when you messed up, you would be in a hole for a very long time. And that's not something that I was okay with. It wasn't acceptable to me. I think it definitely helped me grow as both a person and intellectually. I don't believe, just by looking at my other friends, I don't believe I would have gotten the education that I wanted and that I needed for school right now. Definitely in the writing aspect, if I didn't come to Weston.
The classes were good. They prepared me for the world. I went to Morris Brown College in Atlanta, majored in mathematics and aviation. The strict and stern guidance of the teachers here, how they didn't babysit you, they give you an assignment and it's done and it's due. You know, they don't keep checking on you. That really prepared me for college.
To this day, I never worked as hard in college as I worked in high school. My first year of college, I'm going, this is college? I didn't even make what we call the 90 Club, and I don't know what the academic equivalent to that is. I wasn't one of the scholars, but I'd done that all by the time I'd gotten to college.
Being at Western, an all-girls school, taught me leadership that I would have never, ever learned in a co-ed school, particularly at the time I attended, because at that point, it was sort of anticipated that girls would be subordinate in terms of leadership positions, subordinate to the males. And so here, we had the opportunity to be leaders within the school. And I think forging relationships with other girls who had aspirations, et cetera, we could build on that leadership and learn from each other.
For me, when the idea of going to a single gender school didn't appeal to me, of course, at first, but once I got here, it was, it was the perfect environment for me to grow as a young lady and to really get an idea of what sisterhood really means. I think there needs to be more of that today. As I hear young women talk and, the media, if they had that sisterhood that we had here at Western, I think they would probably be better off.
think the idea of going to an all-girls school does have its merits. There's a focus that you can learn here, and a self-discipline that you can learn here. There's a camaraderie between females that you can learn here too.
I think that the reputation of Western High School, the acknowledgement of its high academic expectations and delivery, I think the fact that many young women see in Western High School an opportunity for leadership and mentoring and collaboration with other young women is something that is sustaining. And its reputation expands well beyond this city. There was a period of time when the federal government challenged single-sex schools, and I had to deal with the challenge of them saying this should be a co-ed school. And I always was able to defend maintaining it. It wasn't maintained at Poly, it wasn't maintained at City, but maintaining it here because of the uniqueness of this program and the contribution it made to women and leadership.
There's lots of research and that has shown that oftentimes girls become silenced in the presence of boys at certain ages, starting usually at upper elementary school and middle school, and definitely by high school. And that oftentimes there is, even if subtle or subconsciously, there's intimidation factors, and that we often become somewhat repressed and somewhat suppressed in that environment. And so I believe that it's a great opportunity for us to find our voice at that very early age, and then sustain it later on.
I'm an advocate for single gender schools. I've not only attended them, but I've also taught in two single sex institutions, one being Western, the other St. Benedict's Preparatory School for Boys in Newark, New Jersey. And I feel that single sex, particularly secondary schools, give students the opportunity to grow socially and emotionally in a bit of a vacuum that is helpful for the adolescent stages.
Choir dignity means to me being ladylike at all times, being able to get out what you need to get out without becoming angry or using profanity, but being able to be ladylike and dignified with it.
For me, quiet dignity is it's the epitome of being a lady, a young lady. It's getting your thoughts and your feelings across appropriately, respect, and just really knowing who you are and understanding that you can get your message out or whatever that you need to communicate in a very dignified way.
Quiet dignity is one's ability to share your thoughts, opinions, fears, just to express yourself in a way that does not require you to be boisterous. It does not require that you are rude. It gives you the opportunity to get your point across and to just even share things about yourself in a way that remains dignified and causes others to pay attention to the level of dignity at which you hold.
More than anything, just the camaraderie and the sisterhood that you achieve by being a Western High School student is so important and so meaningful. People think that they compare it to being part of a sorority when you're a Western Dove, and it really, really means a lot for life, for your entire life.
We're happy for each other when we know that there's something good that's happened in each other's lives. So I think that was instilled in us through Unity Day and just through a sense of unity and pride from being Western at Western together. It was a sense of, for lack of a better word, sisterhood.
And when I think about it now, and as I've gone through my adult life, and I meet other women and they say they graduated from Western, you can see it. You can just see it.
Yes, I have quite a few relationships that started here at Western from my little sister as well as my big sister's class. So we all still have a really, really great bond. And wherever I go, when I meet people that graduated from Western, we kind of gravitate toward one another, and we continue the sisterhood that was started here, even if we didn't know each other while we were here going to school together.
But just meeting the different women, whether they're from the 40s, the 50s, the 60s, and you know, we had some in the 30s, just hearing about their experiences at Western, and whether it was the old Western downtown, whether it was the ones that moved into the new building, the ones that might have been on an A or a B schedule. But you know, all of us have that very warm smile when we talk about our memories or experiences here at Western. I think Western has such a rich legacy, and it has a very strong foundation that's been put in place for all of us. We have so many people that have come out of Western that have gone on to do great things. I mean, how many people can say that they had a graduate from their school install a president of the United States? Or we've had people that have gone on to Broadway. We've had people that have become, you know, judges, lawyers, doctors, engineers, people that have excelled in all different areas of different careers, and they were Western women. And that makes you feel proud, knowing that this one school, whether regardless of what campus you went to, could develop those type of women. I first became involved with the Alumni Association when they were reactivating the Alumni Association in the late 80s, early 90s, and I was still a student at Towson State University then. And one of my former teachers, Jacqueline Frierson, reached out to me and asked that I have an interest in doing that. So I told her I did. So I paid my money. My name was going to be on a plaque to show that I was part of the reactivation team. And at that time, Floreen Robinson was president of the association, and they were really trying to rebuild it to get it back where it had been in previous years. And we used to do phone-a-thons to get people involved. We had all-year reunions even back then. And we would have other activities just to try to engage and make sure we had a diverse representation involved in the Alumni Association.
When I graduated, I was not even aware that we had a Western High School Alumni Association. So maybe, I'm gonna say maybe 7-8 years ago, my daughter was in a program with a Western alum, and then she was telling me about the Alumni Association. So I came to my first meeting, I immediately got involved, and then as time came around, I've been the fundraising chair, mentoring chair, vice president, and finally the president. Not everybody feels like I do or has the time to give back. So it's hard, you know, when you realize that there are thousands of ladies that graduated from the school, but then you have a few here and a few there that are available and willing to help at any given time.
And this school needs to be supported. It needs, I mean, I get something out of every time I come on the assemblies, but our Western ladies need to know that there are people who came before them and that we've succeeded and that we're here. We're here for them.
I would say to the parents of young ladies today, to give Western a chance, to give Western a try.
I would encourage every parent who has a young girl who is a willing learner and a hard worker, because the demands are not going to be compromised here and should not be compromised here, to seriously consider this school. Because it's a foundation. It's a real foundation for life and for future academic work. And I think parents would be very remiss.
And now, everyone join in and sing Dear Western, a song written in 1913.
Dear Western, we greet thee with songs of thy praise and with hopes that unchanged may be.
Dear Western, we greet thee with songs of thy praise. Dear Western, we greet thee with songs of thy praise and with hopes that unchanged may be. Dear Western, we greet thee with songs of thy praise and hope that unchanged may be. That forever in safety each ship thou will guide.
Forever in safety each ship thou wilt guide o'er tempests, over destiny's sea.
May our colors on I wave proudly on high. May our name be linked unto fame.
For we love thee now, love thee, and ever shall love, and ever shall honor thy name.
For we love thee now, love thee, and ever shall love, and forever shall honor thy name.
Woo! You are bold.
My gracious. Is that enough? Why didn't she give me the questions? Why didn't she give me the questions?
All right, that's good.
Thank you, Lynette. I can't believe her.
That's wonderful.
I'm not a singer. My daughter is.
And with hope, and with tempest of destiny, see. Thanks.
My name is Anitra Washington, graduate of the class of 1995, and I am a proud Western High School graduate.